Hey YouTube, I'm back with another video. As I said before, I'm breaking down my makeup collection. I think in my next video, I'm just gonna show you like where I keep all my makeup and stuff so you can see why I'm breaking it down. But tonight, I just wanna go over all my primers that I have for my face. These are face primers, not eye. I'll start with the first one. This is Revlon Age Defying Instant Firming Face Primer. I'm not sure if they still make this or not. I picked this up at my local Big Lots a few months ago. It was around $3.50, I think it was. I'm not sure if I'd pay the full price if they still have it, because I think I saw it before for around $12. But it comes in a squeeze tube like this. And if you can see, it's more of a, I'm guessing like a gel, but not really a gel. It don't dry to like a powder finish. If you can still see, it's a little wet. It blends really nice. So like right now during the winter, it's a really nice primer because my face gets a little more dry in certain spots. So I put it in like certain spots that are really dry, like my forehead, around my nose, and things like that. If you have a really dry skin, I definitely recommend this, but it doesn't do as much as keeping my foundation staying put all day. I tested this out with no other primer, and my foundation was gone by the time I got home from work, which is 8 hours of work. The next one I have, it was kind of like, it was the old Maybelline Super Stay Foundation, and it came in two different containers. Like the one side had a foundation, and the other side had a super extender part. And I ripped that thing apart and took out the super extender part because I believe it was a primer. It's supposed to keep your foundation longer. So they mixed it together with the pump, but the pump quit working and never dispensed it. So I put it in a little container like this. You can't really buy that foundation no more. That's why I hate showing things that you can't really buy. It looks like this, and as you can see, it's white, but it dries to a clear finish. Now this one has a little more of a drier consistency than the Revlon one, and it has like a, not a weird scent, but it does. But this definitely keeps my foundation on longer than having nothing, and definitely longer than the Revlon one. The next one I have is my Wet n Wild Intuitive Blends Shade Adjusting Foundation Plus Primer. And this one is in 175 Fair. If you can see, it says it right there. Now this one is more of a, it's marketed as a foundation, but I use it as a primer mixed in with a couple other of my primers. It comes in a squeeze tube like this. I mix it and dot it because as you can see, it has these little granules of foundation. You see, it comes on like a light color, and then it blends out to be a skin tone color. Now you can use this by itself, like as a primer plus a foundation, but I use it as more of a primer to even out my skin before I use my foundation. So as you can see, it blends out and actually covers really well by itself. This is around $5, I believe, at anywhere Wet n Wild sold. So definitely try it if you're looking for like an extra step to make your foundation stay and plus look a little better. I use this, and this is like my third or fourth bottle, so I definitely, definitely, definitely recommend it. The next one I have is a Lanacane Anti-Chafing Gel, and it comes like this. This one's kind of the same thing as the Monistat Anti-Chafing Gel, which I have as well. And these two are silicone based. Everyone talks about them being just like the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. I think that's what it's called. They definitely have a gel-like consistency like that, but they go on really smooth and then they both dry to a powder finish. They're not meant for like private parts. They're meant for like your thighs or your ankles or anything when you're running or walking would rub together and cause friction, like a burn. This is meant to prevent it. So if you put it on your face now, it evens it out. It makes my face feel really, really soft, and it's like a smooth canvas for your foundation to go onto. And I'm telling you, these both work excellent. I think this one is around $6.97, $7, maybe a little bit more depending on where you pick it up. But this Lanacane, which is the same exact thing, it's a $2 cheaper. So when I picked up this, I saw this like a couple weeks later. So if you find this one and you can't find this one, definitely pick this one up. It's the same ingredients because I read it before I even bought it. So definitely try this. If you're into the silicone-based primers, these work. They work amazing. The next one I have is the Rimmel Fix and Perfect Foundation Primer. And it only comes in one shade. And now this one, it does have a orange hue to it, and it does have a squeeze top. If you can see, it does have like an orange base to it. You can't really see it because, like I said, it blends out onto my skin. And trust me, I have really pale skin. And at first, I was like, oh no, it has an orange hue and it's going to make my face orange, but it don't. It blends out really, really well where you can't even see it. And it blends really nice. This one's not silicone-y, just like the Monistat or the Lanacane. This one is more of a like a lotiony type of consistency. And my last one that I have is my favorite, which is the Hard Candy Sheer Envy Primer. Now this one, if you can hear it, it's getting a little low, but this one it also has a squeeze top. Now this one, as you can see, it has more of a chunky consistency, as you can see at first, but it blends out so nice. And this one, you can't really tell, but on my camera, but if you see other reviewers, it has like a very slight blue purplish tint, but it's meant for diffusing light as of making your face look a tiny bit brighter, which is not really the case. Like, it evens out your skin tone. Like, for fluorescent lights, like the one above me, it makes your skin like even, just like a primer is supposed to. So, those are all my primers, my face primers. I just keep them in a little container like this. But, I definitely use them all. The normal thing that I do every day is I either use this one or my Monistat or Lanacane. I put dabs of those on my face, put a couple dabs of my Wet n Wild Intuitive Blend, and then a couple dots of this. Just because I mix them all up, it stretches them all, and I ends up being like the perfect consistency that I want, and it ends up blending out really nice. So ever since I've been using any of those are really good. The Hard Candy, I believe, is around $8 at Walmart. Exclusively is sold at Walmart. So if you're looking for a really cheap primer, definitely pick up the Hard Candy one. It's like my favorite one, hands down, or the Lanacane. They both do the same thing. They're both silicone based. I don't notice a difference in my pores, but you cannot see my pores once I put those on. So if you don't have a primer, there's inexpensive ones at work, and it will seriously make your foundation last. Like, all the ones except the Revlon one make my foundation last all day until I take my makeup off, which I try not to leave my makeup on for longer than 8 hours because I just don't like to because I feel like my face is getting dirty. So if you have any questions or would like a further in-depth review on any of those, definitely let me know below in the comments and I will do so because I've been using them all forever, so I know. So definitely do that if you have any questions. And please don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. I appreciate it. Thank you. Talk to you guys later.